Hey everybody, welcome back to Let's Play the Binding of Isaac Rebirth. I'm Nye, and for the love of all that is good, we're going to unlock the damn character this time. Okay, pressing tab to input this seed, because there is no way in hell I'm spending another hour searching for freaking, whatever they're called, mullabooms, whatever the hell they are. I'm not doing it. It's not going to happen. Don't ask me to. I'm not going to do it. The other things? Fine. I will do the other things. I will go and do the runs and not die and all of that. Okay. Alright. Let's just not die to it. You know, that's a plan, you know? Let's just not die to the explosion. How does that sound like for a plan? Mullaboom? Got killed by the Mullaboom. Wonderful. Next run, Maggie. Do I sound a little bit salty? I think I'm a little bit salty, I'll be honest. Saltiness may have been achieved at some point over this damn run. It may be due to the freaking, due to the last run. You know, there is, definitely some saltiness over that last run. And I was really curious, you know, I was sitting there, you know, asking myself, did they change the way Book of Revelations works? Is it no longer guaranteed to give you a Harbinger? Well, it is guaranteed to give you a Harbinger unless you're currently dealing with the double trouble rooms. So it just so happened. I hate this room, by the way. I've got to admit, I hate this room. So apparently, the way it works now is they have these things called double trouble rooms. We got one, and those are the ones where you fight two at once. The really long ones. And if you just so happen to spawn a double trouble room, you don't get the Harbinger anymore. And unfortunately, there's no way to know about that. So, we just got screwed by a fluke, which is basically just Isaac going, oh, by the way, fucker, you're not getting this achievement. We know this is really hard for you to get, and, well, you're still not getting it. So, that's what's up with last run. I'm very unhappy about it. I'm very, very salty about it. So, if I sound annoyed, believe me, it's legit. So, we're gonna do this now. I have extreme doubts that series of circumstances will come up again, so, you know, I'm not bothered. Let's go ahead and just get a health up here. Unfortunately, first room is Abel. If this was a normal run, I'd probably be a little bit upset about the whole Abel thing. I really would, but given that, our only goal in this run is to get down to floor 3 and then blow ourselves to Kingdom Come. Not too worried, to be honest with you. Don't ask me what kingdom will come, but hey, you know. It's whatever. Which is a really weird phrase, to, you know, if you think about it, but I hear that phrase all the time because some of my coworkers like using it a lot, so what have you. Which is also a weird phrase, but at least I understand what that phrase is supposed to mean. Okay, so we got a widow who decided to die an untimely death, which is fine by me. I don't mind smashing spiders like that. Spiders freak me out a lot. It is hard to even describe how freaked out I am by spiders. I mean, bugs in general. If you see me... You send a bug in my direction, I will freak out. Depends on the bug. If it's something like a ladybug or something, you know what? If it stays as far away from me as you could possibly get, you know, I'll be pretty okay. But we'll have these, you know, there'll be spiders that'll be crawling around the walls and stuff like that, and if they get anywhere close, let's not even talk about moths, okay? Because those things, I mean, they'll dive bomb me, because apparently every moth in the known universe, for some reason, has some insane problem with my existence. Which, you know, me existing and being happy causes moths a general pain. And it's a little bit unfortunate, but, you know, there you go. So they'll come and they'll dive bomb me, and when they do, oh, I will just jump out of my chair. Or I'll jump off to the left or something. Like, I will be jumping in general. And, very, very likely to hurt myself in this case as well. So, long story short, me and bugs. But, you know, something like a ladybug or something like that. I actually had a green ladybug, or at least a insects that look like green ladybug that for some reason decided that it wanted to lay on my comforter today. I don't even know how it got in my room, much less on my comforter, but you know, there was no hurting it. And for some reason, even though I am completely disgusted by cockroaches, and you better believe me I am, very, very not happy with cockroaches, but even though I'm not happy with cockroaches, generally I try to scoop them up in a glass or something like that, and I will take them out to another location, generally outside, scoop them onto the floor, and that'll be it. I don't know, for some reason, as long as they're not moving much, if they're leaving me alone, I can be okay with them, but, you know, it's... No. And then but for some reason, spiders. I don't know why. Actually, you know what? I bet you I could tell you why. When I was a kid, a long time ago, I went to the Audubon Zoo in New Orleans, and they had some sort of spider exhibit, and I recall very clearly, there was a zookeeper who was telling us about all of the unfortunate things that would happen to you if various spiders decided to start gnawing on you. And he told us about, you know, wounds that would liquefy, and they would, you know, the wound would never go away, and this one could kill you, and... You know, I'm no expert on child psychology, but I have this straight... Oh, damn it. Fine. I am no expert on psychology, but I have this strange feeling that telling a child that this thing, this so innocuous looking tiny thing that, you know, also has reports saying you eat 8 of them a year, true or true not as it may be, but this really, you know, innocuous little thing, telling a child that, oh, by the way, this can kill you, is generally not a good way to go if you want that child to grow up happy, you know? So, it was just not a good time. So I'm sure that probably had something to do with it. And I'm sure my parents were laughing a little bit at the time, but, you know. Things, right? But yeah, I'm sure that's where it came from, so generally I forgot about spiders, and it doesn't help that, you know, when I used to live in Colorado, you know, we didn't have black widows all that much, but we had the brown recluse, and which is apparently also a deadly spider of some manufacturer, some type. And I'm sure it didn't help to be told that there was this really, like, basic-looking spider that, oh god, that can kill you really, really quickly. So, you know, combine that with the, whatever that gigantic crab thing is, that there's that famous picture of it on a garbage can, and, camel spiders, and, oh dear god, you have ways to just make me cringe. As such, I am very likely to kill, the widow and the wretched without mercy, and, I hold no love for the cellar in any of its incarnations. What? No love at all. Like, this place is crappy. I'm gonna do this just for kicks, because you know what? Health means nothing to me right now. Oh, did you look at that? Ow. So there's our item room. Might as well. Fortunately, these runs with Maggie do not really last long enough to build up money to be tossing into the, shop. That's a real shame, because, you know, any money I do earn on Maggie, even if it's just 1 cent or anything, you know, it could be used for something. And I've got to remember that. Even the runs I don't do anything with, you know, if I'm not having a good money run, at the very least, if I get to Mom, you know, would you die, please? Toss that money into the shop or something. I've got a long way to go before I max that out. Apparently, we're going to be going with number one. I don't really mind. You know, we'll play with number one just for kicks. Doesn't really matter. The run ends on the next floor if all goes well. So that's a thing, right? Now, it may just be me, but I have this really extraordinarily hard time figuring out how Maggie is getting a stream of number one to come out so straight and true. I mean, I'd have a question just about anybody who was somehow making that particular magic happen, but, okay, well, apparently that happened. I only really came in here to see if there was anything I could trade for that I didn't already have. So I guess we'll do this. Maggie just looks so happy. Like, there's this look of bliss, of pure joy on Maggie's face, and I've got to wonder, Maggie, why are you so happy? This is not supposed to be a happy day. Okay, there's the bomb. On to Judas. Negative 13 wins right now. I am not pleased by that. It's not as if I had a really good record to begin with. Libra, as usual. It's not as though I had a really good record to begin with, to be completely honest with you. But, there was always that feel of, 1-2 wins, on a game like Isaac, you're doing well. There's always that. And then all of a sudden, it just goes away. Now, the good news about Libra, among other things, is that Libra does indeed give you 6 bombs, 6 coins, and, 6 bombs, 6 coins, 6 keys. So I'm set for the duration of the run. There's another Able. I'm kind of amazed that those are coming up so fast. So we should probably use that to the best of our ability. Maybe not to make this the best run that it ever was, but, I have 10 cents right now. That could become a good shop donation if there's nothing in the shop that I need to keep us going until Mom. Now, do recall that because of Libra, Book of Belial will not be quite as amazing as it could be otherwise. It's not going to be the most amazing item, but it is. Libra is just amazing. It is one of my favorite items in the game, just because of the extraordinarily weird synergies it has. I would just love. At some point, that's wonderful. I would love at some point to have Libra and Libra and Soy Milk at the same time with something really stupid powerful, like Proptosis, for example, and see what I can make happen. That would be so damn fun. So that is my hope. We're gonna go ahead and pop that right there, get some more Spirit Hearts or the Small Rock. So we will be getting a little bit of a damage upgrade, of course, but it's also gonna be upgrading us in a lot of other ways. So that's pleasant. Let's see, what are they offering me in the shop? Battery. Oh, you know what? I might as well. Let's go ahead and pop that. We'll grab that, and we'll be good to go. Let me charge up. We'll buy a little bit more often, be able to use it more often. Should be a fun time. Okay, so this would be a wonderful first level, all told, in a normal run. And the game seems to do that on purpose. Hey, you're going to be going pretty far today. Let's just make sure that you don't get all that stuff that you... Or let's make sure you get some really good items, so that way you can feel bad about not having these. That's fine, though. So, kind of the unfortunate thing about Libra is that Book of Belial becomes a little bit less useful. We get a little bit more, we get more speed and more range and everything, more attack speed. And, of course, we do get damage up, but it's not quite as much as I would like it to be. That being said, I'd be kind of curious about the damage calculations to know. Given that we do get an attack rate up, with the attack rate up, do we end up getting more damage or less damage than Book of Belial by itself? Very, very curious question. A curious case of Benjamin question. Go away, you. Okay. So we have enough, we do have enough keys to cover basically the entirety of the run. Let's go ahead and pop in here. Spider Butt, I'm just gonna ignore it. I'm not gonna even bother picking it up. And instead, we're gonna go this way. Okay. I am kind of curious, given that spider webs slow us down, does Libra balance that out? It's a very, very weird question. Does Libra balance out the slowdown of spiders? And hey, for that matter, the slowdown of something like death. I am very curious. Get my bomb back. Excellent. Don't really need it, but hey, it's always a cool thing when that happens. Definitely want to see if we can go back into the shop. Maybe there'll be something else waiting for us. Something interesting. I'm always going to look out for something interesting. I'm always on the lookout for fun little runs. Runs that just do stuff. Runs that go somewhere. That have something weird or interesting going on that is, potentially out of the ordinary. I love them. I love seeing those odd little interactions where things don't go exactly according to plan. You either have to figure out what's going on, figure out how to make it turn to your advantage, or it's something so good it's already to your advantage. Those happen a lot too. So we got two key doors. One's going to be a shop, obviously, and one is going to be a book of secrets with a hanged man and a fool. I'll definitely take the hanged man. Let's see if we can just pop the book of secrets real quick. And that really didn't give us anything. I think from the Book of Secrets gives you a map first, which unfortunately we already had. After map, I believe it gives you, let's go ahead and pop this right now. After map, it gives you, I think it gives you compass after map, and then lastly it gives you, blue map, so you have the treasure, all of your little things. Unfortunately, because we used Book of Secrets, we did lose the extra charge on Book of Belial, and that really matters all that much. Now, what I didn't know, and apparently is true, Book of Belial guarantees on each floor that you will be gaining a room. Does this actually work? It does. Neat. But it will guarantee that you get a devil room. I actually did not know that it guaranteed it. So when I was so surprised about us getting so many angel rooms last game, that really, that explains why that happened. So we have excellent damage. Shouldn't be too hard to get to Mom. I think we're going to be just fine. We have everything we need. Early Libra's just amazing that way. Now Libra is going to take a little bit of the damage that we normally get from Abaddon and shove it into other locations. Not too bothered by that, to be honest with you, but it is something to note. Sure, I'll take Sad Onion. I think that lowers our shot speed down by a lot more, but it does give us the Toxic Aura. It does let us shoot through walls, so I think I can live with that. It changes our look, too, which is very odd. We definitely have a weird skin condition. We keep on going from white to black to white to black. It's odd. Two of clubs, let's just double our bombs. I don't really care. Doesn't really bother me one way or the other. Isaac's fork, 100% worthless for us. Just dodge that shot as we move on. There's a Mullaboom. Not that we need them anymore. If I needed a Mullaboom, I could find one, thank you. There's our boss. Definitely want to go visit the shop just for fun. That said, let's see what the boss has to offer. Go ahead and pop ourselves our Book of Belial, and we will just wreck the hell out of this guy. You know what? Let's pop it twice. See if that helps. Do we get more damage out of that? I can't quite tell. Explosives. And explosives. Get ourselves a halo. Gives me a little bit of health. And inside the boss room for, of course, Krampus. If he could give me the lump of coal, I would just be incredibly happy about it. Fear Shot's going to make it a little bit unpredictable. That's cool. Oh, and I run right into him because he turns the direction I wasn't expecting. Not going to pick up Gramps' head, thank you. I have absolutely no interest. There wasn't a... Nope, no small rock in there. Okay, four bombs, only one really good location for a secret room. Except it's not there. Anything else I want? I mean, this is only Catacombs 1, so we got time. Oh, dear. Okay, we got it quick. Everybody's blown up. Is this going to be something good? Bomb and a key. Not bad, but not good. Let's see. Yep, I kind of expected out this. So the secret room should be either to my left or to my right. Could be either one, apparently. Wasn't expecting this room to be quite that large. It's fine, though. I think I'm going to go for the lucky poop, petrified poop. A little bit more than I'm going to go for... sure, let's do that. Gives me more fodder for the devil. Pride... Right, you're funny, buddy. Could you not do that? Look, I'll be over here. Thank you for opening the secret room for me. I appreciate it. And he gives me a card against humanity, which might as well use in. Well, let's use it out here. And the reason why we're going to use it outside is it gives us more poop for our buck, and then that will allow me to get more money. Would you look at the money already rolling in? It's as if I actually knew what I was doing before I did it. Nah, couldn't have happened. Let's go ahead and break all of that. This could possibly be a little bit of the poop acting up, if that's the case. The petrified poop, that is. If that's the case, that's fine. We're getting plenty of money. I'm going to be able to play in the shop, and I'm definitely going to donate a lot of this. And we're going to see if we can break the machine again. Ooh, definitely good stuff. Look at all this money. Man, I'm kind of pleased with the card against humanity, to be honest with you. If it is weird that it does fill up an entire room full of poop. 56 cents. We started with 14. That's a lot of cash. That's a lot of cash indeed. Inside here, we find Mom's purse. Not bad. Just gonna sit here. Ah, damn. After three? Really? That's all you're gonna allow me to put in today? I can see forever. Would have liked to have that on the next floor. Sure, why not? It's not as if it means anything right now, honestly. Okay, moving on. So we got some good stuff going on here. Good run. I'm enjoying it. Even knowing that it is guaranteed to be a loss. I guess it's kind of the same way you feel about something like, Halo Reach or something like that. You know you're gonna lose, right? You know the storyline. You know where it has to go. There's no doubt in your mind that it's gonna be a loss because you already know where that goes. Okay. Yeah, you already know where that storyline goes. So, you know, there's no question. But you still play it, you know. Oh, get wrecked, dude. Okay, so it looks like it doesn't stack up twice. Which is kind of weird, but I'll take it. Or kind of like how Tran says that, I think it's, what, Twilight Princess? Link is destined to lose in the first place. It was always a foregone conclusion. Don't really like that idea, personally. I like the idea that Link is the hero that can win. But, you know, there's always that idea that, hey, this may be just the way things happen, right? Okay, so we're not quite back up to Combine Thresher, but hey, we are really damn close. We move fast. We slice like a boss. Everything is looking good today. And yet still guaranteed to lose. One of the cool things is it looks like we do have Spectral Shot. So that's going to allow me some stuff. I'm just going to pick this up real quick. Thank you. Double some of our stuff. I love having, let's see, what did I get that got me Spectral Shot? Was that Abaddon? Is that how Abaddon works? I found pills. Question mark is paralysis, so that's a shame. Let's go ahead and blow that up. Nothing? Okay. Look, okay, come on, let's not do this. Not interested. Look, I got a Combine Thresher. I frankly don't care for your bullshit. Me and my Combine Thresher don't care for you and your bullshit. Should be able to get that. Anybody have the thing I'm looking for? It's okay. I'll waste bombs. Lockdown is generally not considered to be a good thing. Eh, sissy long legs. If I had to choose, this would not have been the item I would have chosen. You know, I'd like an item that actually allows you to unstick the, donation machine. That'd be nice. Let me just throw in some money, you know? I have tons of it. Let me get rid of some of it. Just sitting here, it's not doing me any good. It's definitely not gonna help in this room, or in this run. Lemon Party's nice. Not something I mind. And luck up. Okay, so we have luck down and luck up. Man, if only we had PhD, we could actually make that real damn good. Not likely to happen, and not as if it really matters, honestly. That's this run, guys. It is a foregone conclusion. We lost before we ever won. Lost before we had a chance, really. It's a shame. Are you looking at this run? Are you seeing the nonsense that we are pulling off? This run's amazing. Break you into pieces. And we get ourselves Mask of Infamy. Yeah, really good run. Big, big shame that it's that, you know. I'm gonna have to kill myself. I mean the good thing is, I guess, that I, you know, in normal mode Judas, I don't need anything. You know, there's no thing that I need to unlock, you know, nothing that I haven't done. But still, such an easy win that I could be having. Easy and pleasurable. Like, I would love to see what this would do against Isaac and Blue Baby, and what nonsense we could come up with in the chest, because, you know, there's always some, like, Proptosis that works ridiculously well. I would just love to see it. Can't, sadly. Okay, over here should be a, we get to look forward to seeing a mini-boss right here. Excellent. Let's just go ahead and pop that real quick. Go on, go ahead and die. Nope. I guess the whole, let's pop it right here. Why not? Is that useful? Chariot. Diamonds. Neat. I guess the whole giving the Book of Belial a guaranteed Devil Room chance thing was kind of there to help balance out Juice a little bit. He's got definitely increased damage, but, you know, the one health thing really kind of nukes him a little bit. And Book of Belial definitely did used to give you all kinds of good, chances to, I don't want to do that early. I think I might do that early. Eh, not really anything I can do with it because I don't have anything. We're going to keep the credit card. See if the shop has anything I care about. I'll probably just buy out the shop and then we'll use the credit card, with the Joker. I've been told it works at least with the trinket, with store credits. I'm kind of curious if it works with the Joker. I kind of imagine, the credit card. Kind of imagine it's gotta, right? I mean, you don't put an item in there like that and then just not use the ability on its like items, you know? I don't know, maybe I'm wrong. I'm sure you guys will let me know. Well, I'm sure I'll find out, but, you know, I'm sure you guys will let me know anyways. In here we find Box of Spiders. I don't care. Not even a little bit. Got ourselves our Flying Sphincters. I don't care if that's not their real name. That's what I'm going to call them. How about down here? Got some hollow. Dropping poop everywhere. We are getting so many bombs. It is just, it's really funny, actually. Blow you up. I'll toss one of these right here. Not going to play with him just yet, though, because I really want to go to that shop and just see, is there something? Shop's got to be somewhere around here. Let's not forget that we do have Liberty Cap, so Liberty Cap's going to be getting us some mushroom effects. Could get some odd mushroom, some skinny mushroom, fat mushroom, skinny mushroom, magic mushroom. Got some options. Definitely going to be picking up one of those and one of these. Awesome. Got ourselves a long room here. And I guess I'll donate, you know, 4 cents to the I'm a Dude Who Has No Money fund. That sounds like a plan. Let's go ahead and blow that up, too. Probably should open that up before using the, bomb. Might have got me more out of it. It's amazing how long it takes for me to break that open. I guess I'll take Counterfeit Penny. Not that big of a deal, honestly, but, you know, it's there. And that's the last, I mean, I have bombs. Why don't I use them? Because that's a pit. Okay, well, that answers that question. Let's go, there's another bomb. Let's go donate about 8 cents to this guy. That's cool, man. I don't need hearts. Do you have anything else in there? Breakfast. Okay. Allows me to play with my next deal with the devil. Which is guaranteed to show up, apparently. Okay. But then again, we do have credit cards, so hopefully I won't even need the health. And for some reason, that girl was frightened. Okay. I am a very frightening persona. Get ourselves blue cap, HP tiers up, shot speed down, so they move across the screen even slower. We need to go deeper, or Dark Bum? Well, Dark Bum, definitely interesting. I'm liking the idea of that. Let's try this. Credit card, and they are free. I'll take the Dark Bum. I will take the We Need to Go Deeper real quick, just in case it opened up into a crawl space. And that's going to be about it. We're going to move on. Okay, what are we looking at? Okay. Oh, would you look at that? Look, it's another beggar. Well, I'm sorry, man. I don't think I have any help for you. I'm gonna be dying in just a second here, you see, and, well, it doesn't really matter, does it? Okay, so let's kindly recall that we need to die directly to Mom and to no one else. Very important that we die to Mom. So I need to make sure that when I get in there, I go in with little health. And the hope really is that when we die to Mom, I'm hoping that I can get myself killed by the foot. That's really what I want to die to. So we'll try that. Anything in here I care about? Eh, not really. I'm gonna keep on moving. We don't even care about, you know, I don't care if I get hit. It doesn't really matter as long as I'm moving. We're probably gonna want to go to the left. Yeah, left has the most terminations, so I imagine that's probably gonna be the case. Doesn't really matter if I get hit. This is my item room, so I get to see what's in here. It's gonna be cute. Nothing's really gonna matter to me. Nothing really matters to me. And you can't even get angry about me for walking over the spikes, because, you know, we need to lose that health. We need to lose a little bit faster. We're only a couple of rooms away from the final boss here. Okay. Let's go ahead and let that cost me a health. One more. And probably one more for good measure. Okay. And good. So that killed me from Mom. Okay, we got one more. This one needs to be Azazel, and the cool thing is that because it's Azazel, we get to have a little bit of fun, but we're also nice and powerful. What I just need to make sure is that I really take my time with this run. I need to die to one thing and one thing only. Ooh, 20-20 double shot. Excellent. But I need to take my time with Azazel. I need to make sure that we really, we play it safe, you know? That's the really, really important thing here, is that we play very safe. Make good decisions. We need to make it all the way to Shoal, and that's a fair amount of time. I'm gonna be kind of speed running it just a little bit, just because, you know, I don't want this run to take positively forever. But you know, we want to make sure that when we're moving around, we want to make sure that everything we do is gonna give us longevity, as if this was a normal run, because it's gonna be about the length of a normal run. Down goes Monstro. Goodbye, you. Synthoil's amazing for damage and range up. We're gonna move on. Okay. Cellar 2. Definitely need to find ourselves a key somewhere. Now, normally when I say that, the game just gives me a key. So the fact they didn't give me a key must mean the game's angry at me or something. That's fine. You know, I can live with that. Okay. What do we got going on in here? We got two golden chests. I don't really have a key, so I can't make that happen. But hey, maybe we can make something happen in a future room, maybe? There's a key. Probably gonna use it more on the item room than I am gonna be using it elsewhere. Its relic is definitely gonna let me get further on in the game. Rather pleased with that. Okay, next we're looking for two more keys for the golden chest. Golden chests, plural. We have potential for a secret room to the right there, but I really want to get into this rock, or this tinted rock here, for a chance at a small rock. That was really silly damage I just took. Another golden chest. This is going to be one of those runs, isn't it? Okay. Can you guys get over here? Over here. Come on. Come on. Ah, damn it. Not worth it. Not worth. Okay, so the question is my secret room here? I think it's probably gonna be right there. Nope, okay, there's only one other place that could really be. That's gonna be right here. Okay, so we don't really get much from that. I'm definitely gonna put a bomb here. And a bomb here. On the off chance that we can get ourselves... Well, pills are good. Pretty Fly is excellent. Pheromones not so much, but hey, a Pretty Fly is good. Okay. Now that does make sure that we get that going. Probably not going to be able to do too much with a Deal with the Devil here, unfortunately. As much as I wish we could. Okay, I can only hit the Ovum, apparently. Do get Panties. Anything here I can do? Cannot do Little Brimstone, unfortunately. Just going to go ahead and move on. Don't mind having Angel Room precedent, definitely. So, and I honestly don't think Little Brimstone would be that good for us right now. He may not even be that good in general. Dead Cat is amazing. Let's go ahead and just pick that up right now. Teleport my way out. There goes my Fool card. Yeah, that's definitely a pretty good pickup. I don't mind it at all on Azazel. Open that up. Bomb key. Goodbye, leftovers. I would love, in an upcoming room... Oh, God. I would love in an upcoming room to see the Holy Mantle, if the game would see fit to give it to me. Probably not, but I have to ask, right? Holy Mantle would be absolutely astonishingly amazing. And would make my life nice. And who knows? We could get it. Definitely not, but we are going to get Book of Sin, which will allow me to garner keys, bombs, soul hearts, sin hearts, and all other accoutrements that allow me to make it to the end. And let's continue on. Bomb flies are terrifying as Azazel, just because I do not necessarily have the range to play with them. Not enough money to really go there yet. That could have been silly just now. No, I'm not gonna... Okay, what about above the item room? I do have one bomb. And, is this... Okay, this is an option. This is an option. That is indeed my secret room, which gives me nothing that I want to play with, unfortunately. So it looks like shop may not be a thing for us this floor. Just trying to stay away from these enemies. Are you a wizard? Doesn't really matter. And spiders. Okay. Pop that real quick. Gives me another key. Wonderful. And in here to whatever the hell this thing is. I didn't even look at its name, and I never do. He's dead already. Okay, so we get experimental treatment, which may or may not actually be worth it. Inside of here, three spirit hearts. I am completely 100% okay with leaving. Yeah, I think that's about it. Looks like the experimental treatment actually gave me a little bit of health, too. It's kind of weird. I'm not used to it giving me health. It happens, of course, but I'm just not used to it. Okay. Do we have any coinage? Should remember that those blue pills are you a wizard? I just didn't. Ah, okay. That was real damn close. Still doing really well in the have you been hit thing. Two clubs, give myself some bombs. Go ahead and pop into here real quick. It's a four. I think, if I remember correctly, that rerolls. Oh, come on. Stop doing that. I don't want to get anywhere near that. There we go. I believe that rerolls all plinth items on the floor. So that's something I want to mess with a little bit later, actually. Unfortunately, I'm not going to be able to go into there. Unless there is... Is this a secret room? No. It's a shame. Okay. Let's go ahead and destroy these guys from over here. And then probably take out the spiders from safe distance over here. We have plenty of health, which is wonderful. Destroy the bomb flies from a distance away. I cannot believe I didn't hit that guy, but that's cool. What's this? two of diamonds. Money, 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 money. Okay, let's, kill those guys real quick. One more. Get away from the bullets. And inside of our item room, we contain cracked mirror. I don't think it's gonna do anything, my reflection. Yeah, nothing at all. Kind of a shame. But, no real big deal. Doing really spectacularly well. Really had to actually wish that said Emperor. Okay, this should not be a big deal at all. Excellent. Pop that right there. Nothing. Are you a wizard again? Empress is good. Gives me a little bit of extra damage. Do not do that. Okay. So we're gonna go ahead and go directly into the boss, which is gonna be Chad. Unfortunately, I don't do quite enough damage to Chad for my own purposes. And there's the achievement for Spelunker Boy. I am so glad that we did something worthwhile in this run. It's been a while since I've gotten that. Unfortunately, I don't think it actually gives you anything this time, but it pleases me to have that item, that achievement, finally. It took me way too long. There's no way that I'm picking up... Actually, Krampus's head's definitely better than what I have here. And now I can just take it easy. So that's all the boy achievements I'm really pleased to note. I guess I'll pick up little Chad, even though he's worthless. Let's go see what we can do in the shop, because there are still some other things that we may be able to accomplish in this level. Still some things of note. I know this level's definitely going to be going long, and I do apologize for that, but it is kind of necessary, given the nature of the nonsense that we are trying to make happen. Let's go ahead and donate, I guess, another 4 cents. That's not too bad, though. We donated about 10 cents over the course of the run. Or the, course of the video. And we did donate a bunch of money on previous runs. I think we donated up to, like, 40 cents in one of them. So I think we're doing really okay when it comes to donations. Don't really care about anything that we can find in here. Mostly just coming here to get my health down. Let's see, is that a secret room? Transcendence. Just a flying item, but I don't know if I actually picked it up. I'm kind of reasonably certain that I have. But there are definitely items that are in the secret room pool that I have yet to pick up, so I'm always going to want to go and check those out. Don't know how I hit that guy. Oh, possibly that. Yeah, that fly. Okay, what are we doing here? Nope. And I don't even care to deal with those fires because I have so many blue hearts all over the place. I mean, it's not even a thing, really. Still can't... Oh, because I just picked up health. That's right. No, what I could do is I could try in the arcade to see if I could get the shell game... to give me a, Skatole, and then see about re-rolling that using the 4, if that is indeed what that ability does, which it may or may not be. I can't remember what the 4 does. Also see if we can get the dollar to proc, for much the same reason. Come here, you. I feel like I'm a drunk. Playing, unable to hit my targets. Either that or a virgin in the bedroom. You know, whichever. One, two, and three. So there's the blood bag. I have really no interest in it whatsoever, so we're just going to go ahead and ignore that. Got some red hearts around here somewhere. Okay, we'll ignore the blood bag, and instead we'll go over here. So I have at least one thing I can reroll. And I have a kind of hoping that inside of here there'll be another item for me. Yeah. Let me go ahead and hit the 4. I think that's what 4 does, right? Yep. I almost certainly taken all stats up for no reason. From a rather simple fight. Well, we can even teleport out of here because I have no interest in being here any further. I'm kind of amazed that the ladder didn't get rerolled. It's kind of curious. It's a curious case to ladder that didn't reroll. But maybe in here we'll find something amusing? Oh, hell no, that is not gonna happen. We're moving on. I'm leaving. Now, what could have also happened, I'm really kind of hopeful for this. This would be kind of amazing. But if the devil deal is still there, and I have no reason to think that it won't be, the Book of Belial may have rerolled into something interesting. Justice. Was there something in here? Now we picked that up. Okay. Can't remember what was in there. Doesn't really matter at the end of the day. Let's go ahead and hit those real quick. And nope, Devil Deal's no longer here. That's a shame. Okay. Not really interested in doing an entire gauntlet for one great chest right now. We're really doing well on consumables. Not worth. Doing really good on damage, too. Gulp Penny. Not a bad trinket. Don't really need it at this point in the game, but definitely not a bad one. Nothing in there for me. Golden chest contains money, which, you know. I, of course, need money. That's one of the things I need the most of in this run. I'm really glad the starter deck showed up just as a fun little thing. Especially because all the pills seem to suck. Let's go ahead and check down next. Oh, well, that's not happening. Left. Not needed. Go away. Keep looking at little Chad, and out of the corner of my eye, I'm just like going, you little bastard, do something. Make yourself useful. And I remembered, oh yeah, he gives me red hearts. You little bastard, do something. You see the relic? The relic is paying out. The relic is doing its job. Why can't you? Don't ask me how that... Okay, I was gonna say. Don't ask me how that didn't hit me. Ah, that hit me. That's fine. This guy's almost dead. Unfortunately, because we no longer carry the Book of Belial, we no longer get Devil Deals. Well, they're no longer guaranteed. I'll still get them, but they're not guaranteed any longer, unfortunately. Definitely going to be offered a speed run at this rate, and I have no reason to slow down. So that's going to be neat. See if it's actually anything good, and if it is, you know, we'll do it. I'm not going to do that, though. You got some money for me? 8 cents. Let's go say hi to Greed. No? No Greed? I don't really care about any of this stuff, to be really honest with you. That could be amusing, though. Let's go see if we... Actually, you know what? I'm kind of curious about that. Let's go see if we can find a secret room, which will hopefully contain, you know, something to the tune of, 7 cents or so. And, if we can... I'm kind of curious what will happen when we blow up, or when we pick up the coin purse. Will it give me, you know, will it give me, 4 cards, or what? What will it do? I'm very, very curious, and I intend to find out. I only have, let's go ahead and get hit once, get hit twice, that should give me all the money I need. Nope, one more? Oh, okay, it's right there. That's what I'm looking for. So just give me all the money I need. Kind of curious where that secret room is. It's probably over there to the left, huh? That's more than likely it. Let's go look. Hello. Oh, look. It was a person. Drop a bomb there. And secret room it is with a golden poop. Drops another meh amount of cents. But hey. The important thing is we have money, and everybody knows that money's important. Everybody. Even kids. Yep, even that one. Okay. What does this drop? It does drop 4 cards. Neat. Judgment's awesome. 2 Judgment, the Sun, and a Hermit. I like the idea of 2 Judgments, so I think we're going to hold on to those, and I'm going to see what happens next floor, where we should will definitely be getting a Deal with the Devil or Deal with the Angel. Technically, I haven't actually taken a Deal with the Devil as far as I'm... Oh, no, I have, haven't I? Yeah, never mind. I've taken a Deal with the Devil. So we'll be having a Devil Room. So what we'll do is we'll... Okay, I can live with that. You know, we've definitely taken a Deal with the Devil. So it'll be my hope that I can use these inside of the Deal with the Devil. And from there, get myself some more Devil Room items. Pop that open real quick. I'm really not expecting there to be much of a problem with the likes of Loki. Especially because he keeps on summoning bomb flies, which I kill him with. So that's not going to be a big deal. We got Monstro. You know, Monstro, get wrecked. Goodbye, Monstro. And done. Let's get ourselves some more money. I'm not actually expecting that we'll, I'm not expecting that we're actually going to end up seeing anything along the lines of, an actual shop in this floor. I'm expecting to see greed, which would be not necessarily a bad thing for me, just because greed's going to give me money. And we're actually going for a money thing right now, so that probably wouldn't be a bad thing. Hello. Ah, damn. Fine, don't give me something cool and interesting. Alternatively, Guppy's collar. Straight to the devil. Okay, so. Let's go ahead and pop this open. What does that have? Okay. So we're here with 36 cents. I think this is a great place to pop one and two judgments. It's a key judgment. Don't want to play him just yet. Let's play the regular judgment and see what he pops out. Breakfast? Okay, so it looks like they're not guaranteed to do devil items anymore, unfortunately. He did pop out a black card, though. Or a red chest, though. Curious if that has something to do with it. Anything? No? Lockpick? Huh. Okay, we'll go ahead and grab breakfast. I'll, I really don't want more, Yeah, we don't want Judas's Shadow. Judas's Shadow would be bad. We'll go ahead and hermit our way over here. Pill bottle may as well be a card bottle. And I don't really care. Okay, we're looking for our item room. Should be somewhere in the vicinity. Kill you. Yeah, I remember the problems last time, so we're not going to pick up Judas's Shadow, because that would be a particularly bad idea. We'd become Judas. We need to become it. We need to be Azazel. So I need to make sure that Azazel is who I am at the end of the day. I don't want or need lard. So that's it. Now we leave. Let's go ahead and find ourselves the boss fight, and we'll go ahead and deal with it. Shouldn't be too trying here. And from here, we should be able to just move along. Oop, whoa. Well, might have lost my speed run because I dawdled. Then again, maybe not. Come on, show me yourself. Show me yourself, and we got it. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and grab the Polaroid, since we're going to be going down. Let's see what the speed run has to offer us. We got Gemini, we got Virgo, Chocolate Milk. I'm just going to go ahead and pick up, not Virgo, but Capricorn. I knew what I was trying to say, I just didn't say it right. Got ourselves a Capricorn. This fight should be nothing whatsoever. Though I really wish I'd given myself a card to get out of here, because I really just don't want to deal with this fight, honestly. But we will get a free item at the end of this, so, you know, there is always that. Unfortunately, unlike last time, I don't have a lovely little critter speeding me through this. I don't know how you even hit me, buddy. Where is the Carrion Queen? Oh, Carrion Queen somehow died. Probably went over there on the spikes. Nope. Okay, come on. You're dead. Pretty easy. We've already seen exactly how effective Loki is at killing me. So I don't expect much of a problem here. I don't know how Loki's a womb boss, to be honest with you. Doesn't make much sense to me. Loki should be a floor one boss, and the womb boss should be, I don't know. Something else. Haunt. Haunt should be the womb boss. So we got some pretty good damage coming out of our Brimstone laser here. Not the best, certainly, but definitely pretty good. Looks like we're definitely one-shotting certain boss segments with it. Which, you know, you may or may not be able to do with certain damage types. That's good stuff. Get over here, pain in the ass. Really don't want that, honestly. Okay, Monstro. Monstro, are you having trouble getting over that small pile of poop there, buddy? I hate Chad and his freaking self-destruct flies. Not that Chubb's much better, honestly, but... And turning on a freaking dime like an asshole. Nope, stop doing that. Don't do that. Damn, you made me miss that one. We are moving through the bosses at a fairly fast clip, which shouldn't be surprising at all. Again, this is Azazel. Azazel just does things. So I am not at all surprised by the speed that we are cutting through these enemies, as if they were butter and we were some sort of implement that cuts and is somewhat warm. Butter or your butter substitute, really. You know, choose which way you play with your toast in your own direction. I'm not gonna say anything against you. That's the way that you want to eat your toast. Got the husk. Got the hollow. Hollow gets cut down to size. I don't know what size a hollow should be, but it's apparently less than this one. Smaller than this one is probably the way I intended to say that, and then it came out all wrong. Just cut through bloat. Bloat dies extraordinarily quickly. For once, bloat died before the Mask of Infamy. Typically, we kill the Mask of Infamy first. So that was kind of interesting. Somehow, the spike still killed the mask. I don't know how that works, because mask flies like I do. So I don't know how that happened, but hey, I'm okay with it. Still kind of upset with the Four Horsemen because they didn't invite Death to the party last time, and I definitely think that's their fault. Death, really, what are you thinking, buddy? That you're thinking that somehow using your hourglass on me is going to work? Man, I know when my time's up. I'm planning on it. I have a party for it and everything. I'm inviting this new guy who I've never met before. But all my friends tell me he's really neat. Okay, where'd War go? War, you done. And there's the recording sneeze. That's how you know this is a real Nigh recording and not a fake. Always make sure that your Nigh recordings have the sneeze of authenticity, folks. Otherwise, get your money back. Match up one more. Excellent. Picked up my Eternal Heart at the exact wrong time, but hey, that's fine. That guy's not going to kill me. Got ourselves a tar ball. And we're out. Okay. 3 floors to go. I need to prepare to get killed. I'm going to have to plan ahead on this one because I can't die on the first or second form of the devil. It has to be the third, and I have to make sure... Okay, that's going to happen. I have to make sure that I, you know, I'm not dying the first or second form of the devil. It needs to be the third one. It needs to be to the feet. It needs to not be to the leeches. If I do it to the leeches, I am 17 different types of bone. So, and honestly, I don't even like being one type of bone. So let's just make sure that it doesn't happen. I'm just gonna go ahead and unicorn my way around here. Didn't work amazingly well, but you know, your mileage may vary when you unicorn. I don't know how you unicorn around, but me, when I unicorn, I don't always unicorn, but when I do, I make sure to actually get shit done. Wow, we have a lot of empty rooms here. Okay. Shuckle, my boy, how's it going? Can you... Look, I'm not even looking at you. Look, I'm over here. Okay. Shuckle has been downed. Bunch of hearts. Unfortunately, the, Tammy's head just doesn't seem to want to last for any reasonable length of time. It's making it awful hard for me to do my job here. look, guys, I'm just trying to entertain some folks here. Could you please, you know, get in your places, learn your lines, do your damn job? Is it so much to ask? It's like I'm working with amateurs here, really, now. Okay. It's like working with off-Broadway stars. I don't know, what is the point behind off-Broadway? Haven't we reached a point where, like, even stuff that is not on Broadway says it's on Broadway now? I was listening to some people talk about that the other day. So I really don't get the point. Like, if you're... Like, what's the deal? Either you're on Broadway or you're not, right? Isn't that how it's supposed to be? If you didn't make it to Broadway, it's because your show wasn't good enough to be on Broadway, so don't advertise it? That's how I gathered it. That's how I always understood it. I'm not going to advertise myself as a front page Isaac star when I'm on page 2 or whatever I'm on. That's not correct. I'm not on the front page. I'm not going to advertise myself like I am. It's weird. You know? It's very, very weird. I never understood why that particular set of spikes was all jagged and had blood on it. It seems off-putting. Well, that was pretty effective. Got a good Joker card. Probably gonna happen, if I had to say. For some reason... Oh, I mean, there's Lord of the Pit. Why not, right? Oh, I could have just used it right then, couldn't I? Oh, man, I just feel like a dumbass. That's fine. We have another floor we can use it on. Not this one, obviously. This one, there's no deals to be had, regardless of what some people will tell you. Yes, the devil will show up. No, he's not interested in playing with you. Nothing in there that I am interested in. Let's just keep going this way. Was kind of hoping that bomb would actually reveal something. I have so much health. It's kind of funny, actually. Just how much health I have. Anything? Nope, anything. Like, I could use the teleport card, just go immediately to Shoal. But I think that would be kind of a waste. We have better uses of it. Why did I find another self-sacrifice room? I don't want one of those. If I wanted one of those, I would have asked. If I wanted your questions, I would have asked for them. If I wanted your insolence, I would beat it out of you. I love that you get to hold a charge while you're doing that. Just makes my life just so much more pleasant when it's like the Shuckle's just kind of there, you know? Okay, if I'm gonna get hit by a leech, now's the time to make sure I get it out of my system for when I fight the devil. Okay, so there's Mom. Or it lives, if you prefer. Not gonna hold it against you if you do. Mom is dead. Long live Mom. Let's go ahead and go down to Shoal. We are almost done, guys. This is the last floor. Let's go ahead and go say hi to the devil. We need to go deeper. Oh, that's funny. Nothing I'm really interested in. Okay, so what we need to do is, we need to get ourselves... We need to make sure that there's a, we need to make sure that there is a set of spirit hearts on the ground that we don't pick up. That's very important. That's part of my plan. What we're gonna do... There's the sun. Let's go ahead and just use that immediately. I guess we'll go up. We want spirit hearts to be on the ground. The reason why is that, we're gonna go to the devil... We're going to let him kill us a multitude of times while there are spirit hearts on the ground. And then when we finally get to the one where we need him to kill us, we're going to go ahead and... okay. That's fine. We're going to let him kill us while there are spirit hearts on the ground out here. And the reason why we're going to do that... Two of spades, sure. Joker. Eh. He didn't have anything I wanted, right? No, not really. Yeah, we're gonna keep, Tammy's head. The reason why we want there to be spirit hearts on the ground is that way we can get enough spirit hearts that I can make sure to survive the encounter with him. So I'm gonna use my spirit hearts now and my actual hearts now. So that way when we get to him, we're ready to go. You know, all ahead steam and however else you want to say that. Anything in here? Suicide King? Okay. I mean, I'll use that. Let's go ahead and just... Well, we're not going to use it now, but... Yeah, we'll use that, We'll actually use that before we even go in to fight him, just to make the fight faster. Eh. We just need to make sure we minimize the amount of hits we take directly off of the devil himself. Okay. Let's go ahead and move into the right. I'm just trying to get as many spirit hearts as I can on the ground. Just to kind of force this. Because I don't want there to be any chance that I fail this, because this would be a rather embarrassing fail. I'm willing to do this for a while. I don't know if I can get it to... Hopefully I can get it to force out some spirit hearts. That'd be nice. That'd be pleasant. Let's hope it does. Could also use some bombs. Bombs would definitely be nice. Let me look for the top secret room. It's spitting out so much money. Just kind of nuts. Okay. Well, come on. I just want to make sure this happens. I'm so worried that we'll have spent this entire hour for nothing if I do not do this right. Not gonna give me... God, spending out all money. I don't want money. I would like bombs, and I'm not getting that either, so... But yeah, we'll go ahead and we'll Suicide King. And hopefully that'll give us some actual stuff. Good, Spirit Heart there. We'll go ahead and open that up. Didn't have anything interesting, unfortunately. Remember, we're going to spawn with one red heart when we do this. So we want to make sure that we're as protected as humanly possible. Anything interesting? Nope. What I'll probably do is I'll probably, oh dear. Forget, these don't, yeah, these, yeah, those things don't turn off. Okay, we're gonna Suicide King. Yeah, those are still there. Ooh, that gives me a Mongo. Neat. Okay, we got the tower, which is not good. The chariot, which is kind of good. Joker again. Okay, there's only so many spirit hearts on the floor at the moment, which kind of disappoints me. Oh, and I picked up what I'm not supposed to be. Oh, crap. I was not supposed to pick up that spirit heart. Because we have not, we have not finished killing ourselves yet. There we go. That's what I'm looking for. Okay, let's go ahead and just kill ourselves. Okay. Keep doing it. Excellent. We're almost there. Gonna have about 4 health. Should be enough, I think, given, given I'm gonna have the chariot, I'm gonna have, Now the chariot. I think that what I'll do is I'll probably use the chariot at the start just to deal a lot of damage to the fallen. Yeah, do I even need that? I don't think I'm gonna even need that. Are there any other cards on the floor that are better? Okay, I got one health left. One more time. Okay. Now we're ready. Let's go ahead and grab that. Grab that. Where else did I leave one? There's one over here. Anything in here? Might as well. Okay, you know what? I want to go play that blood bank. I'm just so concerned about this, and I'm kind of worried that this amount of health will not be enough. Not that blood bank. A blood bank would be counter to the point I want to do. I want to play this slot machine. Just seek. Is there any more... You know, any more things I can do. Just to kind of guarantee my win here. There we go. The foot can stop me all it wants, so that's not going to be a problem. guess I'll do the High Priestess to him. That should help out. Am I good with, like, 6 health? Because that's what I'm going to have at the moment. Another pretty fly would be nice. Okay, you know what? I think I'll be good. Well, let me do this. I don't need the Joker card anymore. Let's go ahead and pop this here. I was kind of hoping we get another one. Okay. Now I feel content. Now I feel like I've done pretty much everything I can to make sure this goes right. You know what? We'll also do this. Okay, that's the most possible health I can have going into this fight. And I'm probably overloading way overboard on this, but, I mean, can you blame me? I mean, can you? That's the chariot, so that's the tower. I would rather take the chariot, definitely. Now we're just gonna go straight in. Okay. So that gets rid of the... That gets rid of the leeches. I took one hit, but that's fine. Now it's him proper. And now I just let him kill me. I just gotta make sure it's the feet, not the leeches. Okay, come on. No leeches have spawned. Come on. One more. It was him, right? You have unlocked the Lost. Okay, guys. The nightmare is over. But in reality, the nightmare's just begun. With that, I'll see you guys next time.